Hi, this is Rainbow Harmony, here to help you find balance and peace to live a more colorful life. And this is a pick a card reading for what is the deeper reason for this sudden turn of events. So if you feel like there has been a sudden shift in your life or a sudden turn of events, then this reading is for you. And what we're going to do is you're going to choose a card here or a crystal that you feel drawn to, and you're gonna get a reading that's gonna help us to uncover that. Keep in mind, this is a general reading, so it may not resonate with everyone. Only trust the parts of the reading that resonate with you, and remember, when you're doing any type of tarot reading, or of course getting any type of advice online, to always trust your own intuition and your own inner guidance above all else. So if you're ready to receive this reading, all you have to do is just choose one of these cards or one of these crystals. Number one, we have the rose quartz crystal. Number two, the red jasper crystal. Or number three, the raw quartz crystal. Once you have chosen, you can head below to the timestamps in the comments or the description, and I will see you soon. So for those of you guys who choose number one, let's get your message about what is the deeper meaning behind this sudden turn of events in your life. Wow, okay, so this card is really standing out to me. So funny enough, this is a card that marks a significant change in your circumstances. So this could relate to your work, your love life, or the entire network of all of your relationships in your life. The message behind this card is to not let your fears and your doubts that you have in your head hold you back. Something really new and really exciting is just within your reach. This is a message to you to jump into the freedom of the unknown. Jump into a life. Take that risk, take that leap of faith into a life of greater beauty and even more fulfillment. This card beckons you to let go of your past. Don't carry around the past like a dead weight anymore. What really belongs to you will stay in your life and will always be available to you. Anything that's not meant to stick will leave. And so just allow the passing of the past, allow these things to leave your life. You could be experiencing a bit of like a tower moment in your life, like that the tower card in the tarot almost, like where things feel like they're falling apart right now, but really everything is coming together in a much better way for you. This is actually an opportunity. There's a fresh slate for you here. This is a big opportunity. You have the opportunity to begin a different life, basically. So the Nine of Hearts is a message about fulfillment, but it also has to do with illusions and dreams. And so this makes me think, in conjunction with this medicine wheel card, that you are in the process of manifesting your dreams right now. I think this has to do with breaking out of a certain situation. I see somebody who is leaving home for the first time, like moving out into their own life. This could be people who are getting divorces or breaking up and moving out from living with a significant other and going on their own path and beginning that life on their own again, being single, kind of starting over. I see people who are getting out of college and establishing their life on their own, looking for work. And I see people who are leaving jobs that no longer serve them and looking for new employment. And I also see a big group of people. I think most of you guys who are here for this reading right now, you're looking for more fulfillment in your life. You're looking to build a different lifestyle. And we can't discount this Otter card here, which is talking about fun. I get a sense like you've just been a little bored lately, and that happens to me sometimes, where you just feel bored, a little complacent, like you've got a bit of a sense of security and stability, and so there's just really not that challenge there in your life, and so you might be feeling a little unfulfilled. And so I do see some ideas you've had, or like some wishes you've had, like, oh, if only I could live my life like this, or if only I could be in this type of situation. And I actually see that the illusion that's been shattered is thinking that once you get to that place, or once you get to that status or that situation or whatever it is that you want, what you realize once you get there, that it's not gonna fulfill you 100%. Like, you have to find that fulfillment inside of you first. You have to bring that energy to each day to enjoy the process. And so it's like you're being pulled back into the present. You're releasing the past, the future. You're starting to see signs that, like, things you've asked for are coming in, or that the work you're doing is paying off. The momentum is going, and, like, you've been staying really consistent, and there's a big change coming, or maybe that's just happened. So it's very exciting, but I feel like the gift that's been given to you is like that gift of presence. And so I feel like the deeper meaning here for you is simply just the word presence. You're learning how to be present as you go through these big shifts. And you're learning how to see these shifts more as an opportunity. Sometimes when it does appear like everything is falling apart, it's just the energy pushing you forward to something new or something you've manifested. So it's exciting. It's hard to release the old, and it can make us feel a little unstable sometimes. But you're actually moving into a lifestyle and a situation that's very fun and that has a lot of opportunities for you. So this is the Bear card. The final message I'm going to leave you with is talking about not hiding from life anymore. The bear is coming out of hibernation and is ready to take on the world, and that's you right now. So I hope this message resonates with you. Thank you for coming to my channel, and I'll see you next time. So for those of you guys who choose number two, let's see what your message is about, what the deeper meaning is here for you behind this sudden turn of events. Well, this is really interesting. I'm seeing the interference card come out. Like, this is what's really happening for you right now. This is a card about indecision. Like, you're having a difficult time deciding for or against anything right now. And this is telling you that there's actually not a need for you to solve all of your problems at once. Rome wasn't built in a day. Your thoughts have their own limitations, so they can only get you so far. And this is talking about clouded judgment, or like thoughts that are going around, or maybe worry or fear. Like, as this situation shifts, it's like you don't know what's coming next, and that's what's difficult. Sometimes it's hard to embrace the mystery of life because it's more secure for us, more comfortable when we know what's coming or when we know what's happening. Maybe that's why you're here for this reading. So this is a message to you to just relax. Let everything that is overwhelming you right now, or that you're feeling worried about, kind of drop off for a moment, and then you can reposition yourself into this situation from a different perspective. So this situation that you're in right now does demand to be cleared up, though. But there's some type of delay in this situation that's caused by, like, outside sources. I think there could be, it's like you're not the only key player in this situation. There might be other people who have opposing agendas to you and opposing views to you involved in the situation, and their energy is, like, going into it, and your energy is clashing with them. It's all getting, like, stirred around. And so this is a message to you to back off and watch what develops from a distance. This delay is going to reveal a more creative solution for you now. So don't push for this decision now. It's okay. You haven't made your choice. This is a message about, from confusion arises only more confusion. So sometimes you have to just step back, let it go, and, like, come back to this situation when you're in a different state of mind. And so this is kind of like an interrupted energy flow right here, but an unforeseen obstacles and challenges. But what's on the other side of this is really positive for you, because this is the card of manifestation. And what's so funny is I just did the reading for people who chose for number one, and what I saw for them was that all of this had to do with some type of manifestation they've asked for. And that happens sometimes. Sometimes when we ask for something, or we set a big goal or set a big intention, like, energy has to shift and transfer in order for that to happen. And the way that looks isn't always how we expect it. And so it's almost like you're like, what is going on? But I think a couple weeks from now, you'll realize, oh, that makes so much sense why that happened. You know, this is so random, but I, you guys know that I travel, but I booked a place And it ended up being very frustrating because something that was advertised to be at this place wasn't there. It was the internet. They advertised Wi-Fi and they actually didn't have it. So it was frustrating. And so I had to cancel the reservation and go through that whole process. And in the moment, I just felt like I was wasting time and I was so frustrated it had happened. But there was a little voice inside of me that, like, you guys know I'm around the tarot all the time. There was this little voice inside of me that was telling me, you know what, just go with it. It's okay to be frustrated about this. It's like causing you a lot of lost time, but just chill, flow with it. And the next place that I got, the host of the place ended up being someone who was like a energy healer. And we actually made friends and I hung out with her the whole time I was there. And she did a really great energy healing on me, which I really needed. And like I read cards for her and it was just really fun. I made a really great friend because of it and ended up in a place that was even better and in a better location. And it just worked out really well for me. So sometimes random stuff like that happens, or you have a delay. It could be a situation like that that's kind of smaller, or it could be something huge that's happening in your life right now in comparison. But I just wanted to share with you what that kind of looks like. I feel like you're in a situation that's causing you to have to just throw up your hands in the air and just be like, all right, well, guess I just have to let this happen. Guess I just have to welcome this energy and see what it's here to bring me, what it's here to teach me. So this is like a do nothing card. And it's hard for you because you have this Princess of Pentacle energy, which is somebody who is very structured, somebody who is a hard worker, an achiever, somebody who's very well liked, somebody who doesn't usually have a lot of conflict with others. Because you have such a bright energy, and it just feels like this is so off to what you normally experience. So it's like, what's happening here? But yeah, your message for you really is that you have to relax and let things kind of drop off for a moment. You might be in your head a little bit too much. There's a little interference here, but it's going to work out well for you if you just flow through. It has to do with some type of big manifestation that's coming in. Everything really isn't what it appears to be right now. So just self-soothe, self-care, focus on your basic needs and just flow with it. Trust your intuition. So I hope that resonates with you. Thank you so much for coming to my channel and I'll see you next time. Peace out. For those of you guys who choose number 3, let's see what's the deeper meaning behind this sudden turn of events in your life. You're at a crossroads in your life right now, and it's a big crossroads. I think that's why we're getting this card reversed. It's a message that you basically have a choice if you are going to take a more traditional path in your life right now when it comes to your career, or if you're going to take a more artistic path. So this could be the difference between someone who's trying to decide if they want to go to school for something like more traditional, perhaps like teaching or law or medicine or something, or somebody who wants to instead drop out and travel or become a painter or a dancer or poetry or cinematographer or something like that. And so you might have some type of talent that you've always been really good at, but it's faded into the background. It's become more of a hobby in your life. And I think for some of you guys, you've even stopped altogether, but you're thinking, I want to get back into that. I want to really take this in the next direction. I really want to be able to make abundance by using my talents, using my gifts, doing something that's more fun for me or more creative or more artistic. And it's like, you're just worried that you won't be supported. You're worried, like, will I make money doing this? Will I be able to pay the bills doing this? And it might also be judgment, because this is something about maybe your family or your society or the people that raised you, or community, or the place you come from, or whatever it is. Maybe it's filled with a lot of people who are on a more traditional path, and it's like very rare that someone does something different or moves to another place or establishes themselves as a musician or a writer or something like that. And so this is the Star card. This is a card has a huge meaning, so many different meanings, but what's standing out to me in this placement is literally like becoming a star, becoming someone who's out there. Maybe you're someone who's like a performance artist or some type of artist. Actually, these cards are really calling to me in my head right now. Let's see. These are all of my artistic gift cards. So I would suggest watching my pick a card reading called What Are Your Artistic Gifts? So you can see all of them and see what you're drawn to. But I feel like there's a lot of people here who have this gift or who have this gift. Like you're some type of performance artist. Somebody who's really good at like expressing their emotions or their feelings, using their voice and their body. Maybe you're good at like theater or music or performing, or YouTube's on here, tarot's on here, what's up? Maybe you're someone who's like a speaker, comedian, or you like to work behind the scenes in this type of industry. Maybe you're a visual artist. You like to draw or paint or do photography or graphic design or interior designs on here, graffiti's on here, installation art, wood crafts, landscape art, fashion design, hairstyle, like, you know, I could go on all day. There's so many different types of art, but basically you get the point. You might be some type of artist, or you might want to experiment with that more, spend more time on that and start thinking about career path with that. And so it's just hard. You're sitting here thinking like, okay, like the inspiration is getting stronger for this. You might be getting better at your craft. Maybe you've already taken some steps in this direction, but there's some hesitation. So it's almost like what's happening around you right now is like a sign. This sudden change of events is opening doors for you to be able to explore this more. So trust that. You might be feeling like everything's coming to a head right now, or to some type of climax. Like, it could for some people be very hard right now, a hard time, like a depression or a sadness or like an anxiety, or feeling like you just want to burst out of some type of prison you feel like you're trapped in. Maybe you just feel like you're trapped in the system or something, you know, like you can't get out and you're going to be stuck here in this situation forever. But this is a message to look on your bright side. No matter who you are, where you are in life, where you come from, all that, there are certain advantages you have in your specific situation if you look hard enough, okay? And I know there's people out there who come from crazy situations. I did, and I've talked to a lot of people who have, or, you know, going through that currently, but where you are right now does not have to define you. Where you've come from does not have to define you. Everyone has an opportunity in this life simply because you're here. You deserve to be able to design whatever type of life you want, little by little. So start where you are right now, where you're at, with the tools, materials, and supplies that are already available to you, and start exploring this creative side of yourself, or working on it, or documenting your process, or creating a portfolio, or taking classes, or going to school forward, or reading up on it, and keep working on your craft, keep honing your craft. That's how you can make a decision. This choice you need to make right now doesn't have to be a huge one. You can still work on your traditional path, or work on developing a foundation in your life to support yourself with some type of job that has to do with something traditional or day job or whatever, and work on this on the side. This could be nights and weekends, you know, while you're supporting yourself or even working towards something else. So this is a hustle. This is like a hustle message for you. It's encouraging you to keep going. Don't give up on the hustle. Maybe you're feeling really tired right now, but sometimes making a choice or just putting a little bit of momentum in a direction that's important to you can stir up your energy again, can brighten your day, can bring that light back into your life. So do what you love. Do what you love. Don't overthink it. This is a message for you to keep on keeping on. So I hope that this message resonates with you. Thank you so much for coming to my channel, and I'll see you next time. Peace out.